Hi, this is Marvin from World Fitness. Today I'll be presenting the newest addition to our leg machines. It's the Body Iron Pendulum Squat. I'm just going to show you how to operate it. The first thing I would do, measure this platform according to like your height, how much depth you want. You've got a little indicator here, so you know if you're somebody that's going to get stuck at the lowest point of the squat, you'd probably boost this a little bit up. By taking out the lock, pulling out the pop bin, placing it a little higher. I like to get low, so I'm going to put a little lower like that, put the locking mechanism in, and then go to the front of the machine to adjust it. So this platform, I can pull out that pop pin. It's on a bearing rolling system. So you've got about a foot of movement backwards and forwards there. That should suit heights from just under 5 foot through to like, you know, you can be 6'6" and still use this machine pretty comfortably, I would think. The other thing that's unique to the Body Iron Pendulum Squat, right, is you can adjust the plate angle. So this one, even though it looks a bit weird, right, I find like I'm not the tallest person, probably about 5'11 when I stand tall, but if I push this right to the back like that and have the platform on this crazy angle, it actually suits me quite well for a deep squat like that. So the weight of the machine with no plates, I'm going to take a calculated guess and say it's going to be about 50 kg. It has a front sleeve. So if 50 kg is too much for you, you can actually load this front sleeve. And I dare say if I load about 50 kg worth of plates on it, it's going to feel like I'm squatting nothing. I'm just going to be moving with no resistance at all. Potentially you might need to start at that level just to get the hang of it. How the machine and your body actually move when in this machine. So one of the great things about the Body Iron version, right? Plenty of brands have like this platform welded and fixed in one certain point, and that might not suit your particular body type, or like you might not quite have the mobility at the angle that it's on. The Body Iron one, right? You can go right through like that. Changing it from, that's like a relatively steep angle, pretty close to vertical, through to that more horizontal angle there. Also, you can move it back and forward, at least a foot, to cater for all different shapes, sizes, and mobility ranges. So why would you use a pendulum squat? Basically, you've got this weight at the back here, and you've got the weight, the front of the machine there, near where you stand, and it basically comes together like a pendulum, sort of like that. So the idea of a pendulum versus like a regular hack squat is regular hack squat can be quite easy towards, like, especially when you're standing up in comparison to when you're deep in the hole. With the pendulum squat, it actually gets a little bit harder on that easier point just because of that pendulum. The weights at the front, right, as you push up, actually go lower and leaves you with this load, creating more tension in that part of the movement that on a regular hack squat is going to be actually easier. So it just creates like a more of a strength curve for somebody that wants to build that top half of the movement. Just a quick example, I'll do a couple of reps and I'll explain what's going on with the strength curve. So basically, unracking the machine. Now as I go down, right, a lot of the weight's going to focus on this end. This side is actually going to get a bit lighter when I go down deep, like that, yeah? But then when I come up, I'm going to be fighting this, and the more upright I become, the more I'm fighting this weight here. So it's going to get a little easier, a little easier, a little easier. But then when I come up, harder, harder. And the higher I stand, the harder it's going to get. So this platform is quite a big plate. So if I was trying to incorporate more quad into the movement, I might start down the bottom of the platform like that. But if I really wanted to, you know, involve my glutes, I'd come right out like that. And do that low bar style of squatting. So I'm noticing about the different foot positions, just having a bit of a play at the moment. The closer I bring this platform forward, the more it's going to be like a traditional hack squat. And the movement's just straight up and down. I'm not really utilizing the pendulum, but it does eliminate the possibility of, you know, having two giant machines in the one garage, being a hack squat and a pendulum squat. So I'll just show you how that looks. So like this, pretty much a hack squat on the pendulum squat machine, straight up and down. However, I'm really utilizing the pendulum. When I go right out, you know, just because I don't have giant long legs, I'm gonna bring it like that. I can go a bit deeper, Megan. I'll take this out. I just move it right here. Totally different muscles worked. More glute, I'm feeling it more hamstring, and I'm feeling it more in the top of the quad versus the lower portion close to my knee, which I feel when I do hack squats. From a more beginner intermediate perspective, right, why you would use this, most of the population would have like inactive glutes. They're really going to struggle to get that range. When you load up the counterbalance, right, it's going to allow you to do the movement with no weight. So basically, you could come up like this. Now, as I'm going deeper, the weight's getting slightly easier. It's only going to get harder when I come up like that. But even for somebody inexperienced, it's going to be really easy for them to develop that new movement pattern, because if someone just starting to squat, just learning the lower body training movements, it's going to be really easy for them to get that blueprint of squatting like that versus squatting free weight or on like a hack squat.
Sorry.
I might rack it a bit shorter. Yeah, so put your feet on. Now stand up. Wiggle that out. Yep. Go on. See? It's weird, isn't it?
Do you hear my crack?
I heard the crack. Come down a little slower and shove your knee. Come down a little slower and shove your knees out sideways, more like both of them. Yeah, like externally rotate your femur. So yeah, from your hip to your knee. Right, one more like that. Yeah.
Like out.
Yeah, go. That's it.
Oh my god, I can't. Thank you.
That wasn't a very good fight.